All right, today we have something that is something very cool. We've used one of these before. This is a French coffee press. Now this one I like for a few different reasons. First of all, it is big. Second, it's easy to take apart and clean, which has been one of the issues that we've had with the coffee presses in the past, is that they're hard to get apart. You have damaged them and things like that. But this one is designed to have what is called an EzDtach system, where it's easy to take it apart so that you don't risk damaging the parts as you do that. But let's go ahead and take this out of the box here. Let's see what we have in here. So here are some replacement screens right on the top here. Let's go ahead and that comes apart so that you can clean it. So we're going to go ahead and put this back together. Now I've got some water here next to me boiling. We'll show you how to put everything in and use this. Now, my wife likes to drink a brewed cacao drink called Creole Brew so that she can heat it up in the morning and take it with her to work. But it looks like we're just about ready with our water here. So I'm going to go ahead and put the grounds in here, just right into the bottom of the French press. So you can see them right down in here. They're down there on the bottom. When we get everything all heated up, looks like it's almost ready here. We'll make sure this is lined up the way we want it to be so that we can get our coffee press in there as well. Go ahead and add it in. So as you fill it up, you can see that it goes right into the coffee press. Now this is a big capacity 8-cup okay, that is all the water that we had in there. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and put the lid on this off. We're going to go ahead and put the lid on. We're not going to push it down quite yet. We want everything to brew, so we're just going to keep it up here with the handle up. Just want to make sure that our lid is aligned right so that we can get a good pour. But when you're pushing down, you know, I just want to go slowly so that you don't force anything up through the mesh. But as you go down, that forces all of those grounds down to the bottom and will keep them there as you pour into your mug or your glass or whatever you're going to be using. And like I said before, we're going to go ahead and be using a mason jar, just so that my wife can take this with her in the morning. I'm gonna go ahead and just keep that lid on it, just so that the pressure doesn't push it off. Creole Brew. And there you go. Those grounds are all down there at the bottom, and then you can just take the lid off to clean that all out, and you are all set.